Hello everybody, here a new video from Rene from Spain. And I'm in my shop, so I'm looking that way in case somebody comes in. But I want to talk about this album, the McAuley Schenker Group. There was the debut album from the McAuley Schenker Group with Robin McAuley, of course, from Grand Prix. You know, he did a record with them called Samurai. And of course, Michael Schenker himself on guitars. And this is an album that came out in 1987, and that on AMI, at least this edition, this is a Spanish edition on AMI Records, and I always love this album. This album is so incredible, incredible good. It's more melodic than the early Michael Schenker group stuff. Plus, you don't hear him like playing the guitar very much, like the way you know from the early days. This is more like songwriting orientated. You know, they were focusing on the radio to create some radio hits. And they had a couple of songs that did quite well. We have Give Me Your Love, that ended, it was on the American chart. Okay, that song. And also, Love Is Not a Game. There was also a song, a single that charted. Also in the UK, they did not bad at all. You know, that song. And those two songs, they also made video clips for those songs that you can see on YouTube. Also, they released a single for the song Follow the Night and a single for the song Time. Time is a great song. I mean, start slow, but then it builds up, and it's just an amazing song. And on YouTube, you can see them performing that song on the TV show somewhere. And of course, Love Is Not a Game, that's an amazing song. I mean, that one is maybe my favorite song from this album. This came also with the lyrics, with a great band photo. So I love this band photo. And customized labels, very cool. I also have this on tape, but I have now only the vinyl with me to show. That's why, okay, a couple of other things. This album was produced by a guy called Andy Jones, and he worked in the 70s, you know, for Rolling Stone, for Led Zeppelin. But later on, he also produced, for example, I'm going to give a couple examples. The first two Cinderella albums. He produced, a lot of albums. He produced an album by Hugh Satriani he did. He did a few albums by LA Guns, like Tales from the Strip. You know, albums that came out after the year 2000. You know, 2005, 2007. He did those albums. Wake the Dead, for example, by LA Guns. That's a great album. He produced that. Stone Fury debut album. He helped producing also the House of Lords, a debut album, together with Jane Simmons. He did that one. Chicken Foot, debut album, you know, with Hugh Satriani. He did the Hugh Satriani album, I said. And he did many, many more albums. Autograph, Loud and Clear, you know, that album by Autograph he did. Tangier, he did that too. And on here, we have a drummer that later on in 93 was on the on EP called FBI, you know, a band called FBI. This was a band put together by Rolf Scheppers when he left, or he was kicked out, Gamma Ray. This was between Gamma Ray and later on, of course, he went to form Primal Fear with Matt Sinner. But he was in the band FBI with this guy, and his name is Bodo Schopf, is the name of the drummer. Let me see. Also, we have Rocky Newton on bass, and Rocky Newton, he was on Hot Tonight, by Lionheart. You know the band Lionheart from the UK? He was playing the bass on Hot Tonight album. And then we also have another guy, that's Mitch Perry. And Mitch Perry is the other guitar player on this album. And he replaced Yngwie Malmsteen on Steeler. But when Yngwie Malmsteen left to Alcatraz, that's when this Mitch Perry became the guitar player of Steeler. And he was in the band from 83 to 84. So it was quite a cool thing, you know, to hear this. Also, he collaborates on The Final Frontier, you know. Of course, Ron Keel was also in Steeler, but they knew each other from there. And he also collaborates on that. And that's it. That was the lineup. Mitzi Perry, Michael Schenker, Rocky Newton, Robin McAuley, and Bodo Schopf. And some of those guys, like for example Bodo Schopf or I don't know if it's Rocky Newton or Mitzi Perry, they're also on some of the two albums from the Michael Schenker Fest, where you could also find Robin McAuley. You know, he was also singing some songs. Or Graham Bonnet. But anyway, we are talking about this album. Great melodic, hard and heavy records. Great sounding album. You know, the producer, Andy Jones, that died in 2013. He was a great producer. He was from the UK, but he died in Los Angeles, where he was living. He was a great, great producer. You can really hear that on this album, how great he was. Everything sounds perfect. Also, you have a keyboard player on here, but it was not an official band member. But it was also quite a cool guy. And his name was Steve Mann. And he worked actually on the album Rough Justice by Titan. He did some backing vocals on that album. You know, legendary new wave of British heavy metal release, you know, by Titan. And he was also playing keyboards on two albums by the German band Letter X. That's why that guy is also on here. And you can hear that. Great keyboards on here. Just, I don't know what more to say about this album. Just get this album. It's just very good. Okay, stay metal, everybody.